Welcome to Splatterlot,
the magical, mythical kingdom where 10 brave young warriors go head-to-head with those despicable defenders as they compete to capture the much-treasured Splatterlot crown.
Go run, boys, Gerald!
Can the defenders keep the castle safe, or will they be overthrown by the attackers?
Their goal is to overcome all obstacles in their way and ultimately crown a new ruler.
So who will tumble, who will tilt, who will teeter, and who will go? Splat!
I'm Dick. He's Dom. And this is Splatterlot.
No, it's not.
Pardon me?
It's a Splatterlot special edition. It's the boys versus the girls, Splatdown.
Boys versus girls? I mean, that's brilliant, but boys versus girls, is that fair?
Now, hang on. We're not going down that route. In this kingdom, everyone gets a right good splatting. It doesn't matter who or what you are.
Actually, what I meant is it's not really fair on the defenders. Oh, because it's going to be carnage out there.
How will they defend the merciless moat? I can see at least 6 attackers getting through, and then if they're lucky, they might stop a couple more in round 2, but that would still leave 4 in the final, where one attacker is bound to take hold of that crown.
I didn't know you cared so much about the defenders.
Well, I mean, they've got feelings too, haven't they?
By feelings, do you mean anger, rage, and hating all the attackers?
Precisely. Here's round 1 in more detail. We start with the baffling barrels and piercing pellets.
If you're neither baffled nor pierced, you then face the slippery slope and rolling mace.
The impossible incline and beastly battle axes follow. If you haven't been in the moat yet, then well done you.
The bridge of disaster often produces disastrous results.
And the wavering warhead will force most attackers to waver before crossing the finish line. That is the moat's challenge.
Now in our boys v girls splatdown, the 3 fastest girls and the 3 fastest boys will progress to round 2.
But that progress will be hindered by the defenders, who dislike girls and boys in equal measure.
Well, I have to say that is very fair-minded of them. In round 1, the defenders line up as follows.
It's our fair-withered fiend, Vane.
Our medieval mischief-maker, Medivha.
And our feather-brained baddie, Kookaburra.
Defense.
Meal.
So, Vane is on slime duty, Medivha has the Splatzooka, and Kook is in charge of the Aqualizer.
Here's Ashvini.
I was attacked by a rooster!
Slip diddly daddy. I wonder if that can be described by any chance as a foul start.
Only if you weren't trying to be funny.
It's your splat on, girl!
Here's Ashvini at the slippery slope.
Ooh, fighting talk from Ashvini. Surely Medivha will respond.
This isn't working.
Well, that wasn't the response we were expecting.
Roll Krakenang!
Now I'm ready.
Thanks, Medivha, but the rolling mace did fine without you.
Ashvini steadies herself on the incline.
Shatterjack!
Well, who needs defenders when you've got a course like this? And unlike a rooster, Ashvini flies into the moat. How will she respond to that?
Go run, boys, girl!
That's just not true. I only drool when I'm napping, when I'm making a sandwich.
Oh, that wasn't a power drool from Vane, was it?
I think it was. The drool hits Ashvini, and she loses her footing.
Here she is on the bridge.
Get out of here. Get out. And she does.
I will never give up.
Ashvini, say
And Ashvini gets a mouthful of the Aqualizer.
Better than Vane's drool.
But she gets up, grabs the warhead, and... Oh, fluffy one.
I think she prefers the moat to dry land.
Fantastic.
10:35 for Ashvini, so she's in the lead.
Only because she was first to go.
Toss me that crown!
Okay, Owen, heads I win, tails you splat.
Oh, tortellini over too far.
Yes, the only thing being tossed at the moment is Owen into the moat. Oh, and look here, he's lost a shoe into the bargain.
I bring the pain and the mayo.
Mayo? Don't get it.
Well, you'll just have to catch up.
What I do get is that Owen has made it to the wavering warhead. Just this obstacle to go.
Not over yet, here comes the water. And there goes Owen!
Les flattis on! And Owen finishes in 6:10. Look up, Owen! Lovely!
I have 0 self-confidence!
Confidently said, Catherine. Here she goes, and boink! Well, that wouldn't help anyone's confidence.
Bam, girl!
Let's see that again. And again. And again. And stop it! Here's Catherine at the bridge.
Oh, great job!
Oh, what do I do now?
Dude! That's not an exercise.
Well, it doesn't look like Catherine's going anywhere soon, so let's leave her and Vane for a moment and introduce the second boy attacker of the day, Ben.
I am so awesome that my awesomeness is awesome.
This had better be awesome, then.
Well, if a mild slip, trip, and dip into the moat is awesome, then that was awesome.
You're going down.
I'm going down. Do you know who I am?
She's such a diva.
There you go.
Lobster lover. Sorry, Ben, you're going down.
And And there's Ben's awesomeness for all to see. Truly awesome. Now, how's Catherine doing?
Do you spot or?
I am woman. Hear me splash.
Ooh, Bobby Bashbox.
See, that's what happens when you don't use a spotter.
But Catherine's conquered her lack of confidence with a time of 7:58. Oh, what a great going there.
Awesome Ben now doing battle with the beastly battle axes.
You're going down.
So it all goes wrong here, which leads to this, that, and finally, the other.
Defex! Ben's made it over the bridge, but Kook is really showering him with that equalizer. Dick, how do you see this playing out? Quite literally.
Well, quite literally, he swings forwards, bounces back, swings forwards, bounces back, swings forwards, and slides into the Chihuahua marbles.
Thank you. And after all that, Ben finishes in 8:41.
Here's our next boy attacker, Tyson.
Cue another awesome battle cry.
Bananas! Oh, sorry, we have no bananas today, Tyson. Just slime from Vane.
Good balance so far on the axes.
Oh, but Floppy Wumpy! Now that was awesome.
Oh, look, we do have bananas.
Yes, and not for the first time. A banana has led to someone's downfall.
How true, but Tyson finishes in 5:09.
That's what you get.
So that's three boys and two girls so far in our Boys v Girls Splatdown.
Remember, on today's show, the three fastest boys and the three fastest girls will be going through to round two.
So far, Tyson's the fastest boy with 5:09. And Catherine's top girl with 7:58.
But that could all change in the second half when our remaining attackers take to the course.
And this time we'll have three girls and two boys who are more than ready to do splattle.
Splattle? I like it.
So at the halfway stage, let's see how our Boys v Girls Splatdown is shaping up.
The battle cries tell us a lot. For example, here's Ben's. Oh, yeah.
I'm so awesome! Even my awesomeness is awesome!
And here's Catherine's.
I have zero self-confidence.
So obviously it follows that Catherine was much faster than Ben round the course.
Ah, but that doesn't really matter because at this stage the girls are actually competing against each other, not the boys. You see, the three fastest girls go through regardless of what times the boys post. And likewise for the boys.
Ah, so in this run, it's like there's a boys' tournament and a girls' tournament.
Hmm, exactly. As our leaderboard will now demonstrate. There we are. Tyson is leading the boys' competition, and Catherine's leading the girls.
And leading the defense, we still have Vane, Madiba, and Kookaburra.
Here's Ida.
I am better than everyone. Sorry, not sorry.
Well, Ida's not lacking in confidence, is she?
Onto the barrels and off them.
Oh, well, that was good. I hadn't even started.
Onto the mace and... Oh, we've got a screamer. Crumple Burger.
Now, here's the thing. Was it the rolling mace or the sheer volume of her scream that forced her into the moat?
As long as it ended up in a crumple burger, I don't mind.
Not more screams.
You're a really good singer.
I am.
Let's do this, ready?
Uh-oh.
Ida. Hi. Ida. Ida. I'm gonna slime you.
I'm very good at singing.
No, you're not.
Thanks, Madiba. I prefer the screaming.
Ida, look, we're only half an hour in. Is there anything you want to say?
I'm Bob White!
I think she wants to be my wife.
Really?
I think so too, Kook.
That's fantastic!
And Mrs. Kookaburra finishes in a time of 10:33.
Oh, screams of joy or horror.
Please make her stop.
Oh, yeah. Splat a lot, yeah.
Chat!
Straight into the action for Daniel.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, no. Splat a lot, no.
Welcome to the game, Daniel.
Onto the battle axes.
Here comes the Vane pain.
Nanky back!
Oh, yes, the pain from Vane is mainly in his aim. Accurate splashing from Vane and tremendous splashing from Daniel.
But despite all that, Daniel finishes in 4:10, the fastest so far.
Oh, quack popples!
What a welcome from Madiba, and it looks like Nina's found a new friend. There it is, her very own slime ball.
Oh, heave over that team!
Nina, who's the boat?
Nina and her new slimy pal there heading down the incline.
Madiba's the boat!
Nina's the boat!
Well, this exchange between Madiba and Nina is getting pretty exhausting.
So exhausting, in fact, that Nina has had to call it a day.
Nerds rule!
Yes, Jason, but will you rule the rolling maze? Whack off, whack attack!
Does he rule from this angle? This angle? Or this angle? No, he doesn't rule from any angle.
Bird bath, son! Bird bath!
That's nice and fresher.
Would you like some more? Say no, Jason.
And Jason's refusal to chat pays off. He crosses the finishing line.
Show me how you'd break dance. Oh.
And because we can, let's help that break dancing out a bit. Looking good, Jason.
But his time of 6:40 isn't.
Oh, watch out, noise. I'm that girl.
And that girl is Brianne.
Twazzle Wong. That girl goes splat.
You gotta show the boys what you're made of.
So does Bianne mean business. She's on the maze. And yes, she shows the boys that she can splat with the best of them.
But it's a splat too far for Brianna. She's perfectly fine, but just can't finish the course today.
Sorry, girls!
So Catherine, Ida and Asvini are through for the girls, and Daniel, Tyson and Owen represent the boys.
Those teams will now battle it out in our very messy second round. Ditch the dungeon.
Boy or girl, one thing's for sure, we'll soon find out who's the daddy in this mother of all splatfests. So, three boys and three girls made it through round one, but in round two it all changes. Four places in the final are on offer, but this time it doesn't matter who you are. It's everyone for themselves. Anyone could be in that final.
Anyone?
Anyone.
What, like Justin Bieber?
Just, why, for competing, yes.
Rihanna?
Well, yes, if she was one of the six fastest round the moat challenge, but look, that's not the point I'm trying to make.
One Direction?
No!
What have you got against One Direction? You just let Justin and Rihanna through.
I haven't let anyone through.
Oh, you've changed your tune. You just said anyone could be in the final.
You know, sometimes talking to him is like herding cats through a waterfall. Because cats don't like water, right? Here's who's through to round two. Our three girls are Asvini, Catherine and Ida. And our boys are Tyson, Daniel and Owen.
So what stands between them and the final? Well, it's the round I like to call Walter.
Yeah, but the rest of us call it Ditch the Dungeon.
So Walter begins with the attackers making their way over the slippery splat walk, which leads to the loathsome ladder.
They must head to the top while fending off the defenders, who have all manner of grimy weapons.
Once at the top of the dungeon, the goal is to claim one of four flags, each representing a place in the final.
Well, when you put it like that, it sounds almost impossible.
It almost is.
Why then do we make it even harder by involving the defenders?
Well, we all love a baddie, don't we? Yeah. I mean, look at you. Defending the dungeon, we have the feisty and fearsome Fatale.
The slightly soiled and ever-so-scary Scab.
And the theatrical and thunderous Thorn.
You're all winners.
Except for two of you.
So the attackers are in the stock market. We have Asvini in purple and pink, Catherine in yellow, Ida in blue and orange, Daniel in green, Owen in red, and Tyson in green and yellow.
Ah! Don't forget Scab with his yell, Thorn with his slime stick, and Fatale with her foam cannon.
And they're off! Once out of the stocks, they head to the gate. And Tyson is flying!
Oh, but not for long, and the rest have caught him up.
That's what happens when you're a keen mustard.
Scab's keen to splat. And so is Thorn. He splats Kath and Ida.
Oh, what's Dan up to?
I'm lucky, Greenie. Here, try catch this one.
Well, it never pays to make the defenders angry, but Danny does well and blocks the goo grenade.
You kneel before Thorn.
Oh, dear. Thorn thinks he is keen to splat a lot.
Yes, but it looks like Danny thinks he's a defender.
Your aim.
I like you.
Tyson's doing well. Hang on, how did that get there? Did you draw that?
Nah, I didn't.
Daniel's down too.
Pick a colour.
Pick a colour, how about green?
And true to his word, Scam takes out our green guy, Danny.
But then Danny takes out Tyson and Ida. Yes, it's a 3-for-1 special at Splatalot.
Hi, Catherine.
Sorry, Fatale, you're going to have to try a lot harder than that. Catherine's certainly not going to fall for... Oh, yes, she has fallen. Cracking punk.
Well, what a fantastic splat is that.
Hi, Catherine.
Owen now making progress.
Hi. Good, how are you?
Uh-oh, she's being nice again. Don't listen, Owen.
Well, she didn't stay nice for long. Fatale prods Owen with a stick and Sniffy Trombonio.
What a prod! Fatale takes out four attackers!
Forget boys v girls, it's defenders v attackers, and the defenders are on top!
A splat strike!
The attackers just keep climbing back up, though! So here comes Catherine. Oh! There goes Catherine! And that creates a splat-a-launch, taking pretty much everyone out with it.
All apart from Tyson, that is.
Yes, Tyson gives us a little twirl, and that just about saves him.
I'm simply the best! Ah!
You missed, so you're not very good.
Hey, mind your manners!
Uh-oh.
What?
Thorn's bringing out the purple plague!
Oh, no! Not the purple plague!
Look at the attackers! They all head for the moat to avoid the plague.
Not
the
quite all. Plague. Ida's still standing. She must be immune.
And that's really thrown Fatale.
Get her, Cap!
Ida's defying the defenders here. Can she get past the remains of the plague?
Well, there's not much left. The last few balls are being scooped out by Thorn.
I'm not a fan for showers. I realize when people stink.
And Scab washes away the plague and the attackers. Can anyone get past these defenders today?
Maybe Tyson can, but Scab's seen him.
Hey!
You think you've got what it takes to be king?
Yeah!
No, you don't. You're going to prove it.
They're closing in on Thorn now.
ding dong dang a whack. Down go Owen and Catherine.
But Tyson's still there.
Not for long. Ta-ta, Tyson. Shooty chumwom.
So near, so splat.
Now, what can Owen do?
He can do pretty well, that's what.
Ooh, but Scab slime balls him off his feet.
He's still there, though, and so is Catherine. But down she goes again for a mouthful of jabber quatwop.
And Owen's escaped the dungeon. He takes a flag and he's in the final.
Who's going to join him? It looks like it could be Tyson and Daniel.
They're at the top now, and they're up. Well, Daniel is. Tyson takes a trip, but it doesn't hold him for long. Nice flag waving.
So all the boys are through. Which girls are going to make it?
Catherine might. Yeah, she's at the top. And she's going to join the boys in the final. Surely that must have helped her self-confidence. Wave it, girl.
Time for the slide of shame.
Ida, show me one more time your rage.
Here is Ida.
You know, I think it's almost worth losing just so you can do that.
Here's Asfini shamelessly enjoying her last slide.
And there's still plenty more enjoyment to come for our four triumphant finalists.
Yes, all three boys, Owen, Daniel and Tyson, have made it through. But keeping the girls' hopes alive is the courageous Catherine. So the crown could still go either way in our boys v. girls splatdown.
But what if the defenders stopped them? Then it would be the boys v. girls v. defenders splatdown.
Too late, we've done all the graphics now. So will it be a brave boy or a gritty girl who overcomes the obstacles and seizes the crown or splatterlot?
Defenders need not apply.
Time for a splat stat attack, I think. Right, you put the hat on.
Oh, yes.
Good, ready?
Ready.
Good. Splat stats for the boys.
There's not much to choose between Tyson and Owen. So far, Tyson has finished second and third, whereas Owen has come third and first. However, Daniel is the man on form. He came first in the moat challenge and second in the dungeon.
And now the splat stats for our remaining girl, Catherine.
Catherine was the fastest girl in round one, but she only finished fourth in round two.
Thank you, stop. Right, take your hat off. So from that, we can predict that Daniel is the favourite. Catherine
isn't.
Well, I was going to say she has it all to do, but is still in with a chance. Here's our lineup for the final once more.
We have Catherine, Owen, Tyson, and Daniel.
Now, it might look like Catherine has an uphill battle to beat three boys, but they've all got a pretty tricky course ahead of them.
And here it is in more detail. It starts with a trip across the Dire Mire and Barrier of All Barriers.
Then it's a teeter-totter over the terrifying tees, which leads to the scary-go-round.
Once on, the attackers have to get up and over the annihilating arm before landing on the gruesome twosome.
If they get past the clobbering cannons, they have to head down the royal ramps and finally leap onto the rock wall.
Then it's just a question of climbing to the top and claiming that all-important Splatterlot crown. It's also just a question of dealing with this lot. In the final, the attackers will be up against all six defenders who will defend this castle with their last splat.
We have Kookaburra, Scab, Vane, Thorn, Vitala Mediva, who are trying to stop, Catherine in yellow, Daniel in green, Owen in red, and Tyson in yellow and green stripes.
And they're off, so the first challenge is the Dire Mire.
Looking quite thick and stodgy today.
Oi,
the Mire, not you.
Oh, I see. Tyson is the first to the barrier. But he struggles to get over. Now Owen makes his move, and yes, he's managed it. Who's next? Will it be Catherine?
No. Owen at the arch.
Hey, Owen.
He nods and then gets a face full of slime. What a greeting. Hot favourite Dan is now over the barrier.
Get your splatter!
Owen on the tees, he's doing well. He dodges the water blast, and yes, he makes it over.
But Dimbledonk.
Tyson timbers on the tees and Catherine crumbles.
Yes, these tees are not everyone's cup of tea.
Owen on the scary go round. Go on, Owen, show them what you work with.
The defenders are getting mouthy.
Grab a diva.
That's
I'll get them down, don't worry.
I don't know what's worse, the splatting or the chatting.
Ooh, beg your pardon.
Owen goes for splat over chat and takes a trip to the grill.
Here's Tyson. Wait a minute, banana wanger. Poor Tyson.
Well, it could have been worse. What if his battle cry had been doggy doodle?
You're right.
So close, yet so far.
Back to the scary go round.
And Owen just can't get round the annihilating arm.
How about Daniel? Well, while he hangs around, let's check on Catherine.
Ready?
Catherine screams on the tees,
which just adds to the collection. What a scream fest we've had today.
Back to Tyson at the annihilating arm. He hangs on, but oh no, here comes Owen.
This could get splatty.
And trickle box.
Back to Catherine, who's still on the tees.
Now, I do like a soft shoe shuffle, but this is not the time for tap dancing, Catherine. Back to the scary go round, and Owen appears to be trapped on the annihilating arm.
Oh, and here comes Tyson, ready for a rematch. What's he gonna do?
Oh, chimnooker.
Something tells me that's not what he had in mind.
Now look at this. After a spell on the tees, Catherine has made it over.
Tyson now first to make a leap for the gruesome twosome.
Live from the castle, it's Splatter Day Night!
I say it best when you say nothing at all, Thorn.
Owen tries and splats, so he and Tyson are both in the moat.
Catherine's making a comeback. All she needs to do is get past that annihilating arm. Remember, the boys are in the water, so this could be her chance.
But look, she's still holding on. She's not letting go.
Something has got to give. Oh, big needle, boy, boy.
Well, it looked like Catherine was hanging in there, but now she's got to go back and start again from the scary round.
Ew, yummy, yummy.
Owen now at the clobbering cannons. Well, they certainly live up to their name.
As does the annihilating arm, which is still causing plenty of concern for Catherine.
Owen, however, has made it to the royal ramp. The defenders really need to step up.
Owen leaps for victory and hootamaloota!
Now Catherine has made it over the arm, but she still needs to land back on the scary-go-round.
Hang on, all this hanging around reminds me of round one. She did something very similar on the Bridge of Disaster.
Which is fine, but she's still behind the boys.
Speaking of which, here's Tyson throwing slime balls at the defenders.
But that just allows Daniel to catch up. They're both on the ramps.
Catherine is still glued to the annihilating arm.
I don't think she's really glued to it, do you?
I wouldn't put anything past the defenders.
Tyson leaps and... oh, Shedsack!
No one's made it yet.
Oh! Kookaburra are there, turning up the water pressure.
Not another one!
No, Scav, it's another two! Bee bubble wop wops!
It's a double splat from Daniel and Owen!
But the attackers keep coming. Tyson and Daniel are ready to take on the wall again.
Fatal and Medivh need to get defending here.
Tyson leaps and falls once more.
But Daniel's right behind him. Can he make it this time? He steadies himself and leaps! And he's made it onto the wall!
The defenders are trying to loosen his grip with all sorts of slime, but Daniel's having none of it.
He's nearly at the top now. Just a couple more steps. Clever use of the Splatterlock logo there. And he's over.
The crown is now literally in his sights, and we have a winner. All hail King Daniel.
You can let go now, Catherine.
Tyson and Owen did well, but there could be only one. So in the first boys v girls splatdown, the boys have emerged victorious.
Yes, and well played to the girls too. I mean, Catherine hung in there, quite literally at times. Mm. But all the boys put in strong performances, and eventually our red-hot favourite, Daniel, seized the crown.
Let's see who seized the splat of the day.
And it comes from Asbinny in the moat challenge, when she slipped, splatted, and splooshed her way off the impossible incline. But now it's time to turn our attention back to the new ruler of Splatternot.
A ruler who has earned his place through three epic tests of
splatty,
speed,
splatty,
strength,
and splatty,
stamina.
King Daniel finished first in the moat challenge despite some spectacular splatting.
He struggled a bit more on the loathsome ladder in round two, but still managed to capture a flag.
And then in the final, it became a battle royale between the boys, and after a few trips to the moat, Dan the Man made it to the top, and he stands before us today as the new King of Splatterlot.
My first act as King of Splatterlot is to have one of you thrown into the moat. I wish I could do it to all of you, but today it will be you, Scab.
Right.
You rock.
Bad news for Scab,
but great news for Splat fans everywhere. Here he is in the Splatterpult. Take it away, Scab.
You'll play for this! You'll play for this! You'll play for this!
Scab, I'd gladly pay three times over to see you get splattered in the moat.
Well, that's all for now. So until next time,
keep splatting!